Hey there, I wanted to talk about climate. And for those of you who would like to take a look at this on the web, you just go to geography.sierracollege.edu, where I teach geography. And then you click on instructors, notes, you find Sean Booth, click to physical geography, and then this is chapter 8. And then I'm just going to even look at these notes here that I have on my iPad. But in general, what the heck is going on with climate? Climate is long-term, weather is short-term. So today we've got a pretty nice day here in California. It's supposed to rain this evening and then clear out in this sort of the beginning of spring here. We are in a Mediterranean climate, and so what makes us different, let's say, than Oregon and Washington, or maybe Georgia and the Carolinas, or the Ohio Valley, or those folks of you who live in New England? And mostly we think about temperature, but it's actually temperature and precipitation. So temperature is pretty obvious. Precipitation, snow, rain, sleet, hail, whatever you want to call it. It's something coming from the sky, precipitating. And there's a guy named Koppen, which I'll talk about later, who came up with a system based on temperature and precipitation. That's key. He realized that climates were really distinct based on those two things. One thing you could do is look at plants. I've got some house plants, and they can't survive here in the Mediterranean climate. But those house plants are tropical. They could survive in Hawaii. So let's just run down some of the climates that we have. The first is a tropical climate. A tropical climate has pretty consistent temperature throughout the year, and also in some places consistent rain. So that's our wet tropical. The second one is where we have a winter drought, and Koppen came up with a system to define that, where it would rain a certain time of the year and then it was dry in other times of the year, like in the wintertime usually. The second climate, if I were to head toward Mexico and toward the tropics, would be a desert. So from the temperate climates between us, it's actually a desert. And I always thought, you know, it would just get warmer and warmer and wetter and wetter. But in fact, there's a desert there, and we'll explain why. But that there's a couple deserts. There's a really true desert, where you'd find cactus and so on. And then there's also the steppe, where you find sagebrush and grass. In Nevada, here in California, we have semi-arid deserts as well. Those are known as steppes. Cruising on to the next category is a temperate. A temperate climate, Koppen came up with the letter C. So, by the way, a tropical is the giant letter A, capital letter A. Deserts, capital letter B. Temperates were capital letter C, as in Charlie. And those temperate climates, there are three types real quickly. One is the marine west coast. That would include northwestern California, also into Oregon and Washington, where we have a wet summer and fairly mild temperatures throughout the year. And then we have the Mediterranean. Right now we're in nice temperatures. It's going to get into the 70s today and gets into the 40s at night here in late February. And we have a very hot summer, along with a summer drought. So that's very distinct, and the vegetation behind me here with chaparral and pine trees is very much a Mediterranean climate here in Northern California. And then finally, another one is the humid subtropical. That's like the Carolinas, Georgia, the southern states, where it's hot and humid in the summertime. You get most of the rain during that time. That's the humid subtropical. So know about that one. Three types. A couple other ones is the D or Delta. Those are known as different names for those. That's why I'm using the letter here. Looking at my notes here, I have to go to the next page here. And then we have humid, microthermal, severe winters. These are, there are two types of these D climates where it snows and snow sticks around. For example, in the subarctic, that's pretty obvious, where we have just a few kinds of trees like the taiga and the boreal forest. That is a subarctic type of climate. And then there's actually a place where it snows, but then it gets really hot in the summer, like in Illinois, Chicago, Illinois, Ohio, in New England. It can get quite warm in the summertime. Even in Russia, I've been to Russia in Irkutsk near Lake Baikal. It does have a pretty warm summer. Vladivostok has a pretty warm summer, but also a very cold winter. So that's a severe climate, the D's. And then the polars are our last one. We've got the tundras in Alaska, just north poleward of the D climates. Now we get into the tundra. And also ice caps, a few ice caps, Greenland and Antarctica. So that's the main system There's one exception, which is a little weird. Here in California, if you go up Interstate 80, that's our highway that goes across the United States. You start in Sacramento, you're a Mediterranean climate. Here in the foothills, we're in a Mediterranean. But then as you head up the hill, you start to get into more of a severe climates where it snows, and those are the highland climates. So that's just kind of a little side. You have in Ecuador, you have snow in the mountains that's on the equator, and that's way up high in elevation. So that's a highland climate as well. So that's just a broad brush overview of the climates that we have throughout the world, and we'll talk about it in more detail.